Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching a workaround for that pesky error that you get sometimes when you're modeling tiny things in SketchUp, where it says number of segments is too large for a given angle and radius. We're going to jump into that after the intro. Okay, so I'm just gonna show you really quick how we get that error, or why we get that error. So I'm gonna hit C here to make a circle for sides. Instead of 24, which is the default, I'm gonna type in 50. And then I'm gonna start to draw my circle. It's asking for a radius. I'm gonna type in 1/16 of an inch, hit enter. And that's when I get that error. Number of segments is too large for a given angle and radius. So basically what that means is that SketchUp has a limit of the detail that it can draw. So when you're doing something really tiny, like it doesn't want to draw the segments so tiny. It doesn't want to draw like those 50 lines that comprise the circle at that tiny scale. So I don't have a fix for this per se, but I do have a workaround. So what I recommend, you can see it drew a circle here, just as an aside. It drew a circle here, but that's actually a 24 segment circle, which is the default. So what you want to do actually is scale up whatever you're modeling. So for this, let's say we wanted to draw that circle, maybe we choose an increment of 10. So 1/16 of an inch is 0.0625. So I might multiply that by 10, which is then 0.625. So if we do the same thing we just did by scale our circle up by 10, we're gonna choose sides 50. And then start drawing our circle. And then instead of 1/16, which is also 0.0625, we're gonna multiply that by 10 to 0.625 for our radius. So I'm gonna just type that in, 0.625. You can see that it draws that with no problem. Now, just to demonstrate this, I'm going to draw a line from our center point to our end point. Just take a quick measurement of that. You can see that that's 5/8. Then when I select this and I scale it, I'm gonna hit S there for scale, and then choose this corner to scale it uniformly, and then type in 0.1 to scale it 10%, because we multiplied everything by 10. And then measure that, you can see it's 1/16, and I also have my little segments. And this is useful for something if you're modeling sort of like 3D printing, you can get to really tiny things that you're modeling. And when you print, it shows the little edges. So you may want to get rid of those. But I would recommend doing this, modeling everything that you do scaled up. And then at the very end, I would save a copy of your original file and then scale down. Because SketchUp, it's really hard to like figure this out. You can see that it's saying that we're at 0 inches. And it's like hard to model things at this. It like just doesn't want to do certain things. And that was fine, but you'll notice that it just like is really hard to model at this tiny, tiny scale. So model larger, and that'll allow you to get the kind of accuracy that you want. And then you want to scale everything down as the last step. Hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.